So Newton Mail has shut down, and as you can imagine, there are plenty of alternatives out there. In today's video, we'll be diving into 8 alternatives that you might want to try. Okay, let's basically explain the situation for you very briefly, because this has been a long story. Newton Mail was created back in 2014, roughly, by a company called Cloud Magic. And it actually changed its name back in 2017, and that's actually when I started working there as a freelancer. I believe it was late 2018 that they shut down, and naturally were bought out in February of 2019 by Essential. Essential have shut down on February 12th. I totally missed this news, and Mike from the chat and Wayne were chatting about it in the comments below, and they prompted me to firstly make this video and also update you guys on that. So Newton Mail will be shutting down on April 30th of this year. And as you can imagine, this is the second shutdown that they've had. So it's a pretty big bit of news. Now, for those who don't know, Newton Mail was a mail application pretty much available on all devices. It was $49.99 per year, but it was a pretty reliable and pretty useful application. When I say reliable, I mean now it's really unreliable because it shut down so many times. But basically, Essential has shut down, and they're shutting down Cloud Magic, the company, and Newton Mail with it. So I know in today's video I'm going to get slated in the comments, but I wanted to give you 8 alternatives to Newton Mail that might be useful. So let's dive in. The first of those is Spark Mail by Readle. Now, Spark is a very popular application. The main reason why it's so popular is it's free. It has some great abilities, like sending later, being able to do undo send, which a lot of people like, and also a very attractive UI. They continue to improve it, and the reliability of Readle services has been really fantastic as the years have gone on. There is a team pricing to it, but this was actually my personal first option when I left Newton. I knew that the service was shutting down, and I went to this application for about 2 months, and I found the experience pretty good, although I did move to another service, which I'll mention a bit later on. So the second service is a pretty obvious one, and that is Outlook. Outlook has been working really hard on their experience. They've got a fantastic looking Mac app, and also because they bought the calendar application Sunrise, they've been developing hard on making a really attractive calendar application within Outlook. The great thing is it's pretty much included in Office 365 plans, so if you manage to get one, you can either go yearly or monthly, but naturally they're going to be reliable because you've got other services like OneDrive, etc., and it's a Microsoft product. Number 3 is MISSIVE. This is actually the email application that I use. It's a little bit steep in price. This is always something I get some bombarded in the comments by. It's $12 per month if you go for the full plan per month, which does add up to quite a lot per year. But in my opinion, it's one of the most reliable and effective email applications I've ever used. I use the responses inside of it to send quick responses, almost like drafts pre-prepared for me, which is really handy. They've got a bunch of advanced features, and for me, it's reliable on all devices. It's hard to find a email application on all devices, and that's what one of the trickiest things is these days. This one's available on web, Mac, Windows, iOS, and Android. So, for example, if I'm on the go traveling, I can actually log in through web and find that all there. I know I get a lot of people saying that this probably does a little bit more than, say, Gmail, but at the same time, you have to have some sort of guilty spurge, and this is definitely my one, I think. So number 4, and this is MailSpring. I've heard a lot of great things about MailSpring. It was previously a company called NYLAS Mail, but they've recently redesigned it, and it does look very attractive. Now, they have sort of posed themselves as a Newton alternative on their website, and they do have features like advanced search. They do have mailbox insights, so you can see the sort of numbers based around your email inbox. And also, they're available on Windows, Mac, and Linux as well. It works with multiple email providers like Office 365, AOL Mail, Google, and etc. And it seems to be a really popular solution for emails out there. So I wanted to make sure to include this one. And the good thing is that it's a free email client. So the next up, number 5, is MAILBIRD Pro, and this is actually only for Windows users. This is a really nice email client that works on Windows, but provides you with really nice custom themes, also allows you to integrate other applications, say Slack and other such tools that might be handy during the day. But it does come with a price. At the moment, they've got a 50% off apparently on their website, and it's roughly about £30 once off, which isn't too bad if you're someone that uses Windows and also wants a reliable email application. I've heard good things, and as you can imagine, they continue to add new features to it as time goes on. Number 6, I'm probably gonna get battered in the comments for it, and that is SUPERHUMAN. This is a $30 per month email application, but it's touted to be the most reliable, speediest application on the market. For those who have used it, they've fallen in love with it, but it's definitely made and designed more for executives that struggle to unblock their email. And apparently this is much more suited for those sort of managers and high-level executives that want to be able to get through their email fast and that spend a lot of time in their day. They have features like snippets, so you can send these sort of drafts with a few keyboard shortcuts, probably a lot less than MISSIVE. They also have a gorgeous UI that works a fraction of a second. We actually did an interview with their CEO, and from my view of the product, from not using it but actually seeing it being used, I was really impressed. So that's one to check out, although there is a long, long waiting list, roughly about 250,000 people at the moment, which seems like a big waiting list. So number 7 is Spike. Now, Spike is more of a conversational email application. You would plug in your personal email accounts and you can naturally start conversations with people directly. It's almost like using Facebook Messenger, but for email, because the conversations look like social media conversations versus email conversations. So it's a much more of a relaxed style, and you can have features inside of that like voice call, video call, file management, and also the ability to see people in real time. So you can actually see them typing their message so you can get prepared. So it's sort of like a blend between Slack and email. It's a bit of a different take, but I thought I'd let you guys know about it because it's like one of those slightly different style email applications, but one that might interest you in your needs for you and your team. So number 8 is ProtonMail. And I've seen a lot of people in this community particularly jump on ProtonMail. It is a real focus towards security. This application is designed in Switzerland and it has real high grade security. I think it's bank level security involved in it. And a lot of people have been jumping on it because of this sort of focus on privacy. And ProtonMail really tries to encrypt, well, they encrypt every single email in helping you to make a conscious effort towards improving your privacy. For a real basic plan, ProtonMail is going to set you back nothing. It's actually, if you want just one user, one account, and 500 megabytes of storage, then that's going to be free. But if you're looking for the pro account, where you can add up to 5 addresses, and you can even access up to 1,000 labels and folders, that's going to set you back €5 a month. But at the same time, you're getting fully free encrypted emails in that free plan, which is fairly good. And naturally, their full focus is on security. So number 9, folks, and that is a very similar email application to MISSIVE. It's called Front, and it works in a very similar fashion. They're much more tailored for teams that are looking to communicate their email collectively and assign things to each other, like conversations. So if you're someone that works as a freelancer and you're getting more and more clients, or you're someone that works self-employed or is a manager and you're looking to sort of hook people into managing your email or getting more effective on email, then this can be a great tool because you can assign people tasks and even assign people emails, and they'll be able to get full in the loop with those team inboxes. So they're very popular for those sort of situations, and that's the only sort of situation I'd say is good for solo use. For myself, I really love the design of MISSIVE, and Front is a very similar, well-designed application, and that's why I tend to go with those sort of tools. I'll be doing a video soon on my channel about why I love MISSIVE, and maybe give you a few excuses of why I choose that as my email application. But folks, that was Newton Alternatives. Please do email me directly if you want any recommendations for email applications. Maybe we can find one that suits you best. But actually, it's a bit of a sad news that Newton's going, but naturally, it's not the first time. And sadly, it's the second time and probably the last. So folks, hopefully I'll talk to you very soon and I will see you in a future video. If you're not subscribed here, it'd be great to have you. We do plenty of videos like this and we'd love to have you in the community. Feel free to comment below as well, all about your sort of experience with Newton over the years, and do like this video if you enjoyed it and found some value. But guys, I'll talk to you very soon. See you in a bit.